Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Destiny Lorenzo, and if you're new to my channel, what's up, what's good, what's poppin'? If you're not new to my channel, you're a returning subscriber. What's good, what's up, what's poppin'? I can get the best of gonna be a mukbang. I ordered Kelly's roast beef off of Grubhub. If you don't know what Kelly's roast beef is, get put on, sis, because it tastes real good. Real good. Oh, I just got a notification. A notification. So I think my food is here. It got here. And I'm so happy. Because your girl is hungry. Oh, I broke the bag. Now why would they staple napkins? I could be your best interest. You know what I'm so mad about? You know what I'm mad about? That literally I wanted popcorn shrimp, and I thought about popcorn shrimp right after I ordered it. Like, I'm so tight, girl, because I literally could have got popcorn shrimp, but almost it called. I didn't get a drink because Krispy Kreme. No, but I didn't get a drink because I have drinks at my house, you know, so not too necessary. What's it called? Okay, let me show you guys what I got. So pretty much I got, it's mad plain because I actually wanted KFC. Because I wanted, like, I was in the mood for some chicken and potatoes, and I don't fucking know. Like, I was in the mood, but obviously they closed by the time that I tried ordering. So I got a regular grilled cheese, and I got chicken fingers with, what is it called? Cheese fries, bacon cheese fries. And I got a strawberry frap. I don't remember if they have, what's it called? Real strawberries in here. I really hope they don't. You know what they forgot? A freaking straw. But it's okay, because I have my metal straw. Hold on, let me get that real quick. Okay, I know that's right. Save the motherfucking turtles. Let me mix this. It's a little watered down, but not watered down, but you know what I mean, like melted and stuff. All right. Oh, don't fall on me. So what are we gonna start with? Male standards. Let's start with male standards. Let's start with that, because a lot of y'all ladies be settling for way less than you deserve. Let me tell you that one. Because these men be thinking that doing the bare minimum is doing something. No, it's not. Doing the bare minimum is not doing something. Like, I heard somebody say, I'm not gonna applaud a fish for swimming. Period. Like, don't let that go through your head, because it's for real. I'm not about to applaud a fish for swimming. Like, what was I watching? I was watching a video. Her homegirl was like, oh my gosh, he held the door for me. Like, you could just tell that he's so chivalrous and he's so generous and whatever, all that jazz. And I'm like, and she was telling me, she was like, well, I was just looking at her like, you're literally applauding him for holding the door for you. Like, has nobody ever held the door for you? Why do men feel like they shouldn't be doing what they should be doing? Like, you should be getting her flowers. You should be taking her on dates. It don't even have to be expensive dates. Like, like cute little stuff. You know what I mean? Like, you should just be doing those things. And people think, if you get those women or people who like the male species think, if you get that if somebody buys, if a guy buys you flowers, that he's doing the most. Like, no, you're not doing the most. I'm not about to be over here like, I'm gonna thank you, obviously. I'm gonna show gratitude. I'm gonna show, like, I'm gonna be like, I'm gonna appreciate you so much for doing that for me. But it's something that you should already be doing, you know what I mean? Like, it's not something that shouldn't be not known, you know what I mean? Like, come on now. Like, I'm gonna teach my son that too. Then you have the girls with high standards. And then the girls with high standards, like me, because I have high standards. I didn't have high standards before. I'm not even going to lie. I did not have high standards. I'm sorry for speaking with my mouthful. But yeah, I didn't have high standards before. And like, I got myself in a situation where it was like, okay, I'm in this situation, but I love this person, but like, because my standards aren't high, I settled for this. You know what I mean? Like, you just can't. So now I've just learned, like, I'm not just about to lower my standards because you can't meet them. What other topic? I haven't even taken a bite of my grilled cheese. Let's see how this tastes, because I'm picky about my grilled cheese. Let me tell you that. I'm real picky. The bread is good. Okay, Kelly's. I don't know if I'm hungry or if this is just good, because I want to take a trip. Ooh. I forgot this was soda. It's pineapple soda, by the way. You won't catch me drinking soda, let me tell you that. But when you do, it's pineapple soda. Oof. That was good. But what was I saying? Oh yeah, I want to take a trip. Like, why is it just separating, girl? Like, I just wanna, like, but like, by myself, you know what I mean? Like, I don't wanna take a trip with nobody else. So. Okay, maybe like a significant other would be good, but right now at the moment it's not looking like that. So I want to take a regular trip to, let's say, Atlanta, Georgia. I know some people who live in Atlanta are probably like, girl. But I do, because I heard Atlanta is lit, and I've never been to Atlanta, so that's where I want to go. Or, like, I mean, I've been to Florida. I don't know, like, somewhere exotic, you know what I mean? Coronavirus and stuff like that, I'm probably not going to be able to take a trip, but... He thought he was gonna get away. But yeah, and I want to have, like, I don't know, I'm just not a friendly person, that's why. Well, like, I don't want to say I'm not a friendly person, I'm just like really awkward, and I have really bad anxiety when I'm around people. So it kind of, you know, doesn't work in my favor at all. I actually hate it. I hate the fact that happens to me. I get so mad at myself. I'm like, girl, why are you so, like, anxiety filled right now in this situation? But it only happens when I'm around a group of people. Like, I just can't fuck with it. Like, this is not my thing. Oh no, it's on my phone. I'm over here talking about, do I have something on my chin? And it's literally a speck on my phone. Nah, but like, I just be telling myself, like, why are you so nervous right now? Like, come on, bro. Like, there's nothing to be nervous about. Like, get it together, for real. Like, just talk to people. Just talk to people. Literally, just talk to people. But it just don't work. It literally just don't work for me. It don't. Like, telling myself that over and over in my head, excuse me, don't work. It don't. That shit's whack, actually. Because when you're in a social setting, that shit's so fucking whack, bro. And when you actually want to talk to people, that shit's so fucking whack. Like, I don't know why, like, this trait has built in me. Like, I don't understand why, like... There's real strawberries in the drink. There's real strawberries in the drink. Just figured that out. Disgusted. I don't know. I'm just the type of person, like, if I'm drinking a smoothie or if I'm drinking a frap or anything in that, like, kind of sense or whatever, I'm not the type to, like fruits in there. Like, it's not my thing, you know what I mean? Coronavirus!
Coronavirus! Coronavirus! I'm telling you, this shit is real!
I don't even remember what I was talking about. Mental health? Anxiety? But if you have anxiety, you know what the fuck I'm talking about. Well, probably you don't have the same anxiety as me, but if you have social anxiety, then you know what the fuck I'm talking about. You know what the fuck I'm talking about. And then people around me be looking at me weird, like, why is she so quiet? Why is she like, mind your fucking business, I'm going through something in my head. Fuck. Shit. I don't know if I'm feeling this grilled cheese, actually. Like, I would probably eat the bread by itself, but the cheese, not really my vibe. I'm getting food coma right now. Ooh, I want to go to sleep. Ooh. Like, what do you think happens when you die? I feel it. But, like, on some real shit, bro. Like, your body stays here, obviously. Stays in the earth, you know. What's it called? What is that called? Disintegrates? Is it disintegrate? You know, like, fertilizer and shit, and when you put... Bro, if you know what I'm talking about, you know what I'm talking about. So, yeah. Your body goes back to the earth, but your soul is energy. And, you know, energy can never be lost. So, I just feel like your soul just roams around. Your energy just roams around and it just waits. I feel like it just waits for its next life, its next chapter, because your soul is not yours. It's like you're renting it. At this point, I'm just going off, but it's like you're renting your soul. You're renting your energy when you yourself or your soul has finally finished its course of what it's supposed to do in this lifetime. It's gonna release the body. So that's why your body goes back to earth. And then after your soul, you know, roams around and stuff, or does what it wants, you know, gets crazy. It waits for its next lifetime. You know what I mean? So that's what I feel like. I feel like there's no end in death. It's just a new beginning. And I love that. Like, I feel like people just shouldn't be afraid of death at all. Death is fucking amazing. Death, we should embrace death. Death is gonna come. And I feel like just being afraid of death makes shit worse for you. Because it's like, why are you gonna be afraid of what's gonna come, you know? You know, I just really feel like people should embrace death and not be afraid of it. And just like, I mean, not want to die, because I don't feel like you should want to die. If you want to die, please talk to me. No bullshit, please talk to me. What should be your next topic? I think I'm done. Like, I'm kind of nauseous now. This fucking grilled cheese smell is killing me. I don't know, man. Like, I want a relationship. I really do want a relationship. I'm not even gonna cap. Like, I want someone genuine, though. Like, I don't want just anybody, you know what I mean? And I feel like that's what people are going for now. Like, they're just messaging anybody, DMing anybody, just, like, not caring. Oh, my God, this is annoying me. You can't just text anybody. Don't do that, because you don't know how people are. You don't know what they could be doing on the side. Like, everybody loves to put up a front of how they really are, and it's just mad annoying. It could get in the way of having a real connection with somebody. Well, I expected you to be this certain way and you're not that certain way. Now what? You just wasted my time. Like, why are you over here acting like you this type of way on social media when you're not? Don't do that. don't do that. Be real, especially when you talk to me. Like, I hate people who tell me what I want to hear or what they think I want to hear, because it's not what I want to hear. It's not what they think, because they see me as a certain type of person, because they see my social media and just want to roll with it and then just, like, you know, go off of that. And it's just like, nah, bro, like, feel my vibe, you know what I mean? Like, actually talk to me, have a conversation with me. Like, I'm actually mad stupid. Like, sometimes I can't even speak English. Even y'all be noticing in my videos. Just be you. Don't feel like you have to Balenci this and this. Like, that don't make you important. That don't make you special. That don't make you cute. That don't make you, like, no. But it's you. It's yourself. It's your personality. It's what you bring to the table. It's how you make me feel. It's, you know, like, how you go about things, how you go about certain situations that happen between me and you. And I figured out, if you're wondering, my type. I really like you being laid back and being very chill, you know what I mean? Because me, I'm a very hey in your face type of person, you know what I mean? So it's just like, I need that contrast between us, because sometimes I can be chill and laid back, actually. Sometimes I can be very chill and laid back, but those moments where I'm like, hey, in your face and all that crazy stuff, I'm gonna need you to tone me down, you know what I mean? I'm gonna need you to, you know, talk to me with a serene voice, you know, tell me things, not tell me things I want to hear, but tell me things that are going to make me feel better. I figured out a lot of things, actually, after my past relationship. Like, I just figured out so many things about myself, and it's helped me grow so much, and I'm grateful. Like, I am so grateful for that relationship, because it just helped me upgrade as a person. It just helped me cut so many childish things that I did, that I've done. And, you know, I'm not fully at my full potential. Definitely not. I am not at my full potential. And I know that for a fact. I'm not. Because it's like, everyone's a student in life. Shout out Helena, because I saw her on her snap. She was ranting. It was about a different topic. Not about this topic, but, like, she said, everyone is a student in their life. You know, everyone's always learning, everyone's always upgrading, everyone's always moving forward. And I love that she said that. Like, that quote literally stuck with me, girl, if you're watching this. It literally stuck with me, because it's true. Everyone's a student. At every moment, you're always learning, you're always grasping new energy, new vibes, new information. And it's the way that you move about it, and you know, use that information that creates you, and that creates your and it just creates your characteristics, you know what I mean? I've just grasped in so much information and so much stuff, you know, with my past relationship, that just helped me build myself and help my characteristics. And it's helped my characteristics and my traits of how I am to just be better, to just grow, you know, to just learn how to be myself. Now, it's also had a lot of setbacks, but that's just another topic. That's just another day, another video. If you guys like this video, if you guys were listening to what I was saying, because, you know, some stuff I was just saying just to say, you know, and some stuff I was, you know, speaking real shit, feel me? But I need to cut it out. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you like this video, like it. If you liked it, comment. If you liked it, subscribe. You already know what to do. All right, guys, have a good day, night, and morning, whatever it is, wherever you're at, whatever time it is, and catch you later.